This is serious. We are going to take on custom functions in Power Query. And once you get this working, I want you to call somebody who loves you in this world and let them know that you got a custom function working in Power Query. And if you are the only one in this world who loves you, then you be proud of your damn self and celebrate, all right? It's taken a while for me to understand these custom functions. Part of the issue is lots of examples of these things, they just show the how-to and not so much the context. And you know how I like to do things here at Excel on Fire. Context matters. How the hell are you going to use these things once you know how to do them? So here's a situation that could lead us up to using a custom function in Power Query. I've got this data for group one, the name and the state. And what we need is to convert, say, Bonnie's LA into Louisiana and Isabella's RI into Rhode Island. But we've got 50 states and several territories like American Samoa, Puerto Rico, Virgin Islands. Here's a master list that goes all the way from Alabama down to Northern Mariana Islands. One context could be, I'm going to get these lists trickling in one, two, three at a time. So there is no waiting until I've got 50 of them to then batch convert them really easily. I need something that will allow me to easily convert these things as they come in. Of course, we got to start by making queries. All right, here we're going to go to data from table. This is the mlist query, and I'm just going to load this as a connection only. Load to, only create connection. All right. Next, I've got group one. Now I'm going to do a left outer join, but of course, I've got to make my query first. Okay. From table. I'm going to select this column, and then I'm going to sort this alphabetically. Next, I'm going to do the merge right here. Combine, merge queries. MList, match up ABB and state. Left outer join, OK. Expand, OK, that's unselected. I want the name and not the abbreviation. Okay. That's what I want. I'm going to call this state name. Now I'm going to close and load this as a connection only. Okay. Now that table two query is what I'm going to turn into my function. Here, I'm going to right click and duplicate this. Now let's look at this code. View, advanced editor. We've got to look at this in two pieces. We have a source, and there's a problem because Power Query hard codes data. We see table two in there. Eventually we're going to have table five, table J, table blue, whatever, but table two is hard coded in there. And I don't want to try messing around and trying to make that a variable. So I'm going to make my source manual, the sort, merge, and renaming of that column header. That is going to be my custom function. To turn this into a function, I'm going to go up here, source, close parentheses, equals. Next, I'm going to get rid of this source line. No more. Done. Now look here. It's showing up as a function, but let's give it a name. F merge. That's what I'm going to call it. Here's the scary part. Seeing if this damn thing works. Let's close this. Yep. Keep data from table slash range. Go here, insert step after, Now I'm going to wrap my function around this. F merge, open parentheses, close parentheses, enter. Ha! Ah! Look at that. Sorted. It's done. The merge. And that name has changed. Ah! Got it. This, if you get this working, this is when you call somebody you love. They should be as happy as you are. Now, I'm going to close and load this. Close and load it too. I'm going to put it right here. Okay. Oh, check that out. Check that out. All right. Now, next we're going to do a pure naked data range. Here we go. Group 2. Data. Table slash range. Okay. All right. I'm going to add my step. Wrap that bad fella in F merge. Open parentheses. Close parentheses. Oh, God damn it. Check that out. Yep. So we're getting our work done. All right. So we close and load this. Oh, man. Check that out. WI is Wisconsin. UT is Utah. We went to lunch. We call that person we love. They're happy for us. They're going to take us out to dinner tonight. Now, somebody else has sent us a new list to convert. Okay, boom. All right, data. Yeah. Insert step. F merge. Boom, done. Close and load that thing. As I said earlier in the video, the context of this matters. If you got these all in one big file or a bunch of files all at once, then you might have a different solution. But here we're looking at a situation where these things just trickle in. And we could do a VLOOKUP every time. No, Power Query. Custom function. I'll see you in the next video.